Leviathan here to some. Driving around a supercar suggests that you have more money than sense. In fact, they may go as far as treating you as their own mobile ATM. So what happens when your mobile McLaren 650 ATM has insufficient funds? Well, up next is a reaction. Before I start the story, I just want to set the context because I know I'm going to get a lot of hate and I don't want to appear like a hypocrite. Yes, I know I do drive a very expensive supercar. And to be honest, I often feel very guilty indulging in some of the fruits of my labor, whether it's enjoying this car or even something as simple as going out for a nice meal every once in a while. That being said, I still do my part to help improve society by dedicating my time, money, and effort. But it's something I keep very personal because that's how I've been raised. So let's get to the story and let's go for a cruise. In this digital world we live in, cash is becoming extremely rare, at least for me anyways. I feel the only people that really use cash are those Instagrammers who like to withdraw their entire bank accounts and take pictures with it to show the world that, I don't know, they know how to use an ATM. That being said, I only use cash for really two primary reasons. One, to keep it as a backup, and number two, given that I live in a city, there is a high concentration of panhandlers, also known as beggars. And that being said, each time I leave the house, I go through this little checklist in my head. I make sure I have my wallet, my cameras, some mint, some water, an extremely tight t-shirt, and of course, some change. I know there's some people out there that believe that they should not give money to people on the street because it's only addressing a symptom and not the root cause of poverty. But look, if you're driving a $300,000 supercar, I think it's just a nice gesture, knowing very well that I'm not saving the world. Keeping change in the McLaren is very challenging. There's just no spaces for change. And in fact, if I leave it in this little pocket, each time I brake hard, it flies everywhere. And believe me, getting change out of holes in the McLaren is very tricky. So I always just keep it in my pocket. In fact, how much do I have with me right now? In fact, right now I have a dollar. So let's just get back to the story. It was a Friday night and I was just cruising over to Lakeshore so I could just escape and just stare at the lake. I know it sounds dorky, but it's just something I like to do because I find looking and gazing at the lake to be extremely therapeutic and mesmerizing. So I was going down Young Street and I stop at a light. I see a panhandler in front of me and obviously I was prepared. So I pull out some change. I don't know if it was a dollar or 25 cents, but I took out the change and I handed it over to the lady. She seemed grateful at first. Then I heard her mumble something and then she threw the coin at my car, leaving a nice little impression on my paint job. Before you guys get extremely angry, there's one thing I want to point out. According to the Canadian Medical Association, 70% of panhandlers would prefer to have a minimum wage job, but they feel they cannot do so because of their mental illness, physical disability, or lack of skills. So as a result, have no other opportunity. And I'll be honest, this experience really did disturb me. I was so puzzled and disturbed by what happened. I thought I was doing a fairly nice gesture. I don't know if she was suffering from some sort of mental illness, or she thought that an ATM drove right in front of her, or if she was just an angry person. That being said, based on my experience, I found that it wasn't really the amount which people were focused on, but more the overall gesture, which I think to be the most important thing. So would I have done anything differently? Probably not. First of all, I was in no obligation to give anything to begin with, and I really just gave everything I had. The biggest thing is really to wipe your memory clean of some of these experiences, but to be honest, it really did disturb me for quite some time, and each time I see a beggar or panhandler now, I do think back of that experience. The sad reality is I've actually started to accept these negative experiences as just part of the supercar experience. It's sad, I know, but I try my best to not let it disturb me or get into my mind because some of the negativity that's happened is just hard to believe, but I guess you're always gonna have these people out there, and I actually feel kind of bad for him. Despite doing a nice gesture like that, it's just something that bites back, but you never know how people are gonna react. Despite this negative experience, in my mind, nothing changes. I'm still gonna continue to do my part, whether it's a small gesture or a much greater investment of my time, effort, and money. I believe it's best to end today with a quote from Nelson Mandela, who said, "As long as there is poverty, injustice, and gross inequality in this world, none of us can truly rest." Thanks for watching. Until next time.